Hi everyone, it's Ben Murnane here, one of the editors with Live and Invest Overseas, and I'm here with John Palumbo, who's been with us, working with us, doing presentations at conferences for quite a while. And John, you recently pursued citizenship by ancestry. Well, it is interesting, and I think it's their loss in a way, because I mean, you're in a position now where you've gone on this journey. You've learned an awful lot about your family history in the process, and you've now ended up in a place where you have a passport that allows you to live in 27 countries in Europe, you know, that possibly opens up visa-free travel to more locations around the world. I'm sure you feel good about the process you've gone on.
I'll give you a great example. I don't own a home in Italy, but I do own one in Greece. And so literally having the Italian passport is just as good. Because in Greece, I would have had to go through the, you know, the whole investment process and the, all these other things to get a passport out of that country, just because I was not a Greek citizen. But in Greece, they have a saying, it's called una faccia, una race, which means one face, one nation.
Yes.
The Greeks and the Italians are pretty much commingled together because the countries are so close, and especially Sicily. A lot of the Sicilians came from Greece, and a lot of the Greeks came from Sicily. So there's so many of those that are there together now that, you know, they have that saying. So when I tell people I'm Sicilian, they just go, you're almost Greek anyway. So it's interesting, you know, from that perspective. So it makes me, you know, I enjoy being able to be a part of the European Union as well as maintaining my U.S. citizenship, because I've had a lot of people ask me, so are you going to get rid of your U.S. citizenship? And I'm like, are you crazy? No. People struggle to get these. I would never let go of this. I enjoy being a part of the United States, and my second home, or really it's my primary home, which is, you know, being a European citizen now. So it's just a great place to be, to have that flexibility. And freedom. I call it freedom, literally, to move more autonomously around the globe.
Oh, 100%. And, you know, what you mentioned there about giving up your U.S. citizenship, that is not, you know, ever a route that you have to go down, you know, if you're pursuing an EU passport, in your case, in Italy. So we're all about here at Live and Invest Overseas having more options, not fewer options.
Right.
So I think that was certainly the case with your story.
Anybody's welcome to contact me if they have a question, whether you want me to mention it here or give my email address out, or, you know, how they can contact me. But I'm a global real estate nomad. I like buying real estate all over the world. And I have bought and sold real estate in a variety of countries throughout Europe and Mexico and South America and Brazil. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I enjoy it. And so the second passport really played into my passion of travel, my passion for real estate. I remember I've had a lot of people ask me, you know, what was the first thing you ever bought in real estate outside of the U.S.? And I said, well, I hate to say this because sometimes I'm a little bit embarrassed, but the first thing I bought was a timeshare. But that was really all I could afford, was a timeshare. And I went two or three times and used it for a couple of years. My daughter and I did. And we just realized our thirst had grown quickly. Mm-hmm. And the next thing I knew, I bought my first piece of real estate in Mexico. And then I bought something in Europe, and I bought something in North Africa, in Morocco. And, you know, my thirst for real estate is also what fueled my desire for a second passport, for that autonomy and ease of traveling and continuing to do the things that I like to do. People will ask me all the time, they go, oh, well, do you speak Greek, or do you speak Italian, or do you speak Portuguese? And the answer is no. They go, well, how do you get around in these countries? And I said, it's easy. I make friends with people that speak English. So, you know what I have discovered, Ben, is that if you just learn how to say thank you, if you learn how to say please, if you learn how to say good morning and good night, these people in all these other countries, because I travel to a variety of countries and I'm thinking, am I going to learn French and Greek and Spanish and Portuguese? I said, I'm going crazy trying to learn them all. So I just say, no, I'm not going to learn any of them, because I have had no trouble getting around in any of the countries with just English. English is a universal language. Yep. Occasionally, yes, somebody will say, you know, they don't understand. But I'll tell you the real miracle worker today. Where is it? Here it is.
Yeah, right.
You know, I've got the translators right on my phone, and now I can simply say a few words. It says it right back to them, and the door opens up. I have friends in these other countries that don't speak English, and we literally can communicate via text messages and in live and in person when I'm there with this device. It opens the world up for me. Yeah. And it literally, there become no language barriers. And there become no, you know, no people that I can't communicate with virtually. So, you know, right. the second passport just really opens so many gateways to the travels and in places. So if I'm not careful, I would start talking more and more about real estate rather than just the passport, because, you know, that's really, yeah. I love it when a deal comes my way and I get to look at it, whether I see it at one of the conferences and I'm listening to, you know, the different people talk about the real estate opportunities, or whether it's something I discover on my own. And so, you know, I just realized that passport was important to me. It really, right. And you know what, even if a person never buys another piece of real estate outside of the country and it's just for travel, I think it's a great option to have as a plan B. And I look at it as a plan B from the standpoint of what if, so, you know, a lot of times people say, oh, if this person wins the election, I'm leaving the country. Well, great. If you've got another passport, you can do that a lot easier.
Yeah, you have a place to go.
I've heard that. Even where you are, you hear people say, oh, if so-and-so wins, I can't stand them. If they win, I'm leaving the country. I'm going, well, guess what? They just won. Where are you moving to?
Right. Yep. So you, with a second passport, you can definitely do it. You know, you have a place to immediately live in legally. And like you say, your second passport just feeds into your whole lifestyle in so many different ways, and not only opens up options, but complements the lifestyle that you have already. So I can totally see why you went for it.
For me, it was a great option. And for my daughter also, she, you know, you don't always, your children don't always follow your same paths or your same ideologies. Mm-hmm. And I'm fortunate that my daughter's proud to be an Italian. She wanted her Italian citizenship. And, you know, she's also a real estate nomad like myself. She enjoys traveling and, you know, looking at real estate. And she has started getting involved in the real estate part of the world. So having her second passport also plays into her visions. And that was not from me pushing her. These are her own desires. I realize if you try to push your kids to where you want them to be, you might as well just push them away because they go in the opposite directions. I guess she finally looked up and she goes, I think Dad's living a pretty good life buying real estate in these countries and traveling.
Right.
And so from that standpoint, you know, I get to enjoy, you know, her company and her visions, you know, sort of align with mine most of the time. So that part's good.
Yeah. I mean, it sounds like a win-win, and I can totally understand why she would want to buy into that lifestyle, because it does sound like a really good one. And, you know, you've built it up over many years and you're still pursuing different options as they arise, be it real estate deals or passport opportunities. So, John, we will include some links for people to get in touch with you with this video. I really enjoyed speaking with you today. Thank you for talking me through the whole story. I know it's going to be fascinating to anyone watching it. Thanks again, and we'll speak to you soon.
My pleasure. And again, if somebody has a question, they're welcome to drop me a line if you're going to include my email address in the links with this. You're always welcome to drop me an email. I travel a lot and I do answer my own email, even though I have a staff of people that work with me, with my business and what I do, I answer my own email. So you'll enjoy the journey. And all I can say is welcome back home.
Thanks, John.